way a culture dies is when people allow it to die. We would like ours to continue. We are putting these dances on tape for the children to learn how they are performed. The Menominees are an Algonquin group. From the Algonquin group, forest people. So you'll see their designs are mostly floral. You will see a lot of blue, red, and yellow colors in their beadwork. The blue is for the north. The red is for the south. The yellow is where the sun travels from east to west. So we have the four cardinal points where four grandfathers dwell. Our first dance will be a welcome dance. This dance is designed to welcome other tribes or other people to where the dances are held. The welcome dance.
Yeah. one of the four grandfathers appeared to a group of women in the form of an owl. The reason for this was to give the women some medicine. He gave them many medicines to cure the sick. Some of them are used yet today. So to thank this spirit for these medicines, the women got up this owl dance, later called a friendship dance, and the ladies choose their partner.
Thank you.
the spring of the year, before the sturgeon came up the river, the Menominees would get together and put on a little dance. This dance was hoping that they would get a good kill of sturgeon. And you will see the dancers as they make motions like the fish swimming in the water, the fish dance. In 1954, the Menominees celebrated their centennial. The reservation was 100 years old. A group of Meskwakis came to help them celebrate. While they were there, they gave him this dance, which is a harvest dance, the bean dance. This next dance was designed to honor the sacred pipes. Later it was used as a contest dance. Now they don't use it as contest dances anymore, so we continue using it as a pipe dance. Pipe dance. In this next dance, you will see an enemy scout scouting a village. What he doesn't know is that he's being watched too. by other scouts. Finally, these Menominee scouts track him down and kill him. Later, you will see the women as they do the scalp dance, brave man dance, brave man dance.
Oh.
This next dance is also a harvest dance. If it was did in the spring of the year, it was prayers for a good harvest. If it was done in the fall of the year, it was a thank you to the Great Spirit for a good harvest. The green corn dance. Oh, yeah. This next dance is a social dance. It was a dance about a dream. An Indian had a snake. It was a real pet. And when this snake got ready to die, he pleaded with the Great Spirit to let him go to the happy hunting grounds with the Indians. So being that he was a special snake, the Great Spirit told him he could go, but he would break him up into parts, and he would have to jump across the water to the happy hunting ground. So the snake was so happy that he could go. You will see how these dancers dance. He went up to the water and measured it off, went back up, and jumped across. The snake dance.
Thank you.
This next dance, the war dance, the Menominees got from other tribes. We don't know how it came about, but so many other tribes do it, so the Menominees dance the war dance. Otherwise, the Menominees have their own war dance that we don't do in public, the war dance.